Hello friends, this video on subject verb agreement part 1 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Topics to be covered in this lesson are introduction, how to use verbs in sentences with multiple nouns, how to use verbs with words like each, every, either, neither, or, nor, how to handle some special nouns, how to use verbs with collective nouns. So the lesson says subject verb agreement. So what do we actually mean by that? So let us look at some examples to understand what we mean by subject verb agreement. Now let us say that we have these three sentences. I am driving, you are driving, and he is driving, right? So if you look at the first set of three sentences, what do you see? So in the first example, I is a first person, you is a second person, and he is a third person, right? So we see that I, you, he, these are three different persons. Now, what happens to the verb? So if you look at the first example, the verb is am. In the second example, the verb is are. In the third example, the verb is is. Right? So even though this driving is also a verb, but if you look at the verb which is immediately after the subject, what do you see? You see that the verb changes. And why does the verb change? The verb changes as the person of the subject changes. Right? So as the person changes from first person to second person to third person, the verb also changes accordingly. Now let us look at another set of examples. So you see, the first example is, he likes apples. So here we are talking about just one person, one boy maybe. In the second example, they like apples. Now we are talking about a lot of them, not just one boy. So you have a couple of children and we are talking about all of them. Then we say, they like apples. Now here if you look at the verb, again the verb changes. With he, we have likes. Whereas with they, we use like. So what is he? He is singular. So we are talking about one boy. What is they? They is the plural form. So as again, the subject changes from singular to plural, the verb again changes accordingly. So what does this show? So this shows that as the subject changes from first person to second person to third person, or as the subject changes from singular form to plural form, the verb also has to change accordingly. And this is what we call subject verb agreement. That means the verb must always be in agreement with the subject, right? And how do we decide what the verb would be for a particular subject? So that is what we are going to learn in subject verb agreement. That if your subject is first person singular number, what kind of verb are we going to use? If the subject is let's say second person plural number, what kind of verb are we going to use? So that's what we are going to study in subject verb agreement. So let us first understand how to use verbs in sentences with multiple nouns. Let's say if you have a sentence like this, is your mom and dad at home? Is this correct? Or are your mom and dad at home? Now, this could be a great confusion whether it's going to be is or are, because here we are talking about mom and dad. We are talking about two nouns. So there are multiple nouns in the same sentence. So what should be the verb? The verb should be the singular form or the plural one. So that could be a confusion. So let us understand, how do we use verbs with multiple nouns in a sentence? So there are a set of rules that we are supposed to remember. So the first rule is, if you have multiple singular nouns joined by and, in that case we use a plural verb. So let us take an example. Mom and dad are going to the market. So here mom is a singular noun, dad again is a singular noun, both of these are joined by and. So therefore, the verb that we are going to use is the plural form of the verb. So singular form would have been is or am. The plural form is are. So therefore, we have used the plural verb in this case. Let's take another example. You and he were playing. So here you again is a singular, he again is singular. Both of them are joined by and. Therefore, the verb which has been used is the plural form of the verb. You and he were playing football. Next set of rules. Two nouns together represent one idea. So in this case, we use singular verb. Now this is interesting. How do we know whether it is representing one idea or multiple ideas? So let us look at this example. My mother and my friend have come. So here I am talking about two different persons, right? So there are two nouns, mother and friend. Now when I say my mother, so let's say this is my mother and my friend have come. So that means my mother and my friend, they are two different persons that I am talking about. So it is as good as two singular nouns joined by and. So therefore in this case we will use the plural verb. This is what we learned in the previous rule, right? So therefore in this case it would be have come. But if we say my mother and friend has come, so what does this mean? This means that my mother is the same person whom I am also referring as a friend. So that means she is a mother come friend to me. So she is the mother, she is the friend, right? So when I say my mother and friend, so I am basically referring to the same person. She is my mother and I'm also referring her as my friend. So my mother and friend has come. So do you understand the difference? In the first example, mother and friend, they are referring to two different people. In the second example, I'm trying to say that the same person is my mother as well as a great friend. So therefore, in the first case, the two nouns are representing two different people. In the second example, the two nouns together represent the same person. That means two nouns together represent one idea, and that is why we have used singular verb. So let us take one more example. The singer and the lyricist are here. So what does this mean? The singer. So we are talking about a specific singer. Again, the lyricist, a specific lyricist, both of them joined by and. So we are talking about two different people. So here the verb would be plural. But if we say that the singer and the lyricist, that means the same person is the singer as well as the lyricist. So he is singer cum lyricist. So in that case, the verb would be singular. The singer and lyricist is here. So please understand this difference very well, because sometimes in your correction omission kind of questions, you often get these kind of fill up the blanks where, you know, you get a statement and you just need to fill with the right form of verb. So these are very small things which need to be noticed. Okay, now we are still talking about verbs with multiple nouns. Now, if you have a singular subject with words joined by with or as well as, in that case also we use a singular verb. Okay, let's look at this example. The old man with a heavy box is coming. So here, old man. So this man is one subject. Again, we have heavy box. So box again is another subject. And both of these are joined by with. So if you actually have subject which are joined by, or you can say if you actually have words which are joined by with or as well as, in that case we use singular verb, because we are basically referring to the old man in this case, right? So it is not that we are saying that the old man and the heavy box are coming. It's like the old man with the heavy box. So that heavy box is also a part of the old man. So overall it is a singular subject. So therefore it is a singular verb, is. Let's take another example. Physics as well as chemistry is an interesting subject. So even though we are talking about two different subjects here, physics and chemistry, but we have used as well as to connect these two. In case I would have written it like this, physics and chemistry are interesting subjects. So in that case, it would have been like two singular nouns connected by and. Therefore, we use a plural verb. But here, the moment we connect them using as well as, together they act like a single entity. So physics as well as chemistry is an interesting subject. So you see, these are very minute things, but they are worth noticing. Let us talk about the next set of rules for verbs with multiple nouns. Verb must agree with the proper subject, not with the noun near it. Now, in a sentence, it is very important that you identify the subject correctly, because sometimes in a single sentence, you have multiple nouns, and as a result, you get confused which is the proper subject. Now, always remember that the verb must agree with the proper subject and not with the noun near it. Let us look at this example. The price of the books has increased. So here we have two nouns. One is price, the other one is books, right? Now, if you look at the verb, which noun is nearer to it? Books is nearer to it, and books is a plural noun. So in that case, the verb should have been plural, but that's not the case. The verb has to agree with the proper subject, and the subject in this sentence is the price, because here we are talking about the price of the books. We are not talking about the books. We are talking about the price of the books. So for price, we will use a singular verb. So therefore, the verb has to be in agreement with the proper subject, and it has nothing to do with which noun is nearer to it. Yeah. Let's look at one more example. The quality of tea, coffee, and juice is deteriorating in this restaurant. So here, if you see, tea, coffee, and juice, these are singular nouns which are connected by and. So for such an arrangement, we always use plural verb, but here we are using singular verb. Why? Because in this case, we are talking about quality. So tea, coffee, and juice is not the proper subject in this sentence. In this sentence, the proper subject is quality, because we are talking about the quality of tea, coffee, and juice. So with quality, we will make use of a singular verb. So the verb is in agreement with the proper subject, quality. Right? But if you have to write a statement like this, tea, coffee, and juice are good in this restaurant. So do you understand the difference? So in this case, your subject is tea, coffee, and juice. That is singular subjects or singular nouns connected by and. Therefore, in this case, you use a plural verb. So it depends on the sentence formation that whether your verb will be singular or plural. So you always remember that the verb must agree with the proper subject. Now let us try a couple of examples. Time and tide dash for none, waits or wait. So here, time and tide. So even though these are connected by and, the two nouns are connected by and, but time and tide together represents a single entity. So therefore, here it will be singular verb, that is waits. Let's look at the next example. Dash Reena and Geeta at home. So it is an interrogative sentence, that is a sentence which is asking questions. So Reena and Geeta, these are two singular nouns connected by and. Therefore, the verb that will be used must be plural. So this will be, are Reena and Geeta at home? The third one, the lion as well as the tiger dash scary. So here, lion is a noun, tiger is another noun, and both of these are connected by as well as. So the moment we connect two nouns using as well as, we use singular form of the verb. So this will be is. The lion as well as the tiger is scary. The fourth one, good news dash everyone happy. So news is, even though it has s at the end, it appears to be plural, but it is actually singular. So good news makes everyone happy. So cool. I think we got an idea about how to handle multiple nouns or how to use verbs in
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple four-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.